Good morning students. Today we are going to solve worksheet. The first problem is write the decimal number for each pictorial representation. Here whole number part is not given. Whole number part is given means a square will be given and the whole square will be shaded. Here no such picture is given. So whole number part is zero here. So put zero. If a whole number part is given, a square will be given and the square will be shaded fully. Here no such picture is given. So whole number part is zero here. Next, out of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 parts are shaded. So in the 10th place we will be having 7. Here we are having 100. Out of 100, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 parts are shaded. So in 100th place we have to put 6. So the fraction is 0.76. Next, complete the table. Decimal form is given. We are going to write the expanded form and the fraction. The whole number part is 0. So leave that. In the decimal part, in the 10th place we are having 6. So it is 6 by 10. And in 100th place we are having 9. So it is 9 by 100. This is the expanded form. Fraction is 69 by 100. After the decimal point we are having 2 places. So we have to divide 69 by 100. That is the fraction. After the decimal point we are having 2 places. 2 places means 2 zeros. So we have to divide 69 by 100. So that is the fraction. Here expanded form is given. We are going to write decimal form and fraction. 10 plus 5 plus 2 by 10. 10 plus 5 are whole numbers. 10 plus 5 is 15. So whole number part is 15. Next, 2 by 10. So in the 10th place, that is in the decimal part, first number is 2. So the decimal number is 15.2. Next, we are going to write the fraction. After the decimal point, we are having only one place value. So we have to consider it as 10. So we have to divide 152 by 10. So 152 by 10 is the fraction. 10 plus 5 represents whole number. 10 plus 5 is 15 and the decimal part it is 2 by 10. So we have to put 2 in the decimal place. And after the decimal point we are having only one place value. So we have to divide the number by 10. So it is 152 by 10. We should not keep decimal point in the fraction. Remember that. The third question is write the place value of the digit in bold. I have underlined the bold digit. We are going to find the place value of the underlined digit. Here it is 8. 8 is after the decimal point. And the place value of 8 is 10. So we have to divide that number by 10. This is a place value. After the decimal point, it is 10th place. So we have to divide that number by 10. So 8 by 10 is the place value of 8. And here, after the decimal point, we are having 901. We have to find the place value of 0. 0 is in the 100th place. So we have to divide that number by 100. 0 by 100 is the place value of 0. The place value of 0 is 100th place. So we have to divide that number by 100. So 0 by 100 is the place value of 0. 0 by 100 is nothing but 0. So the place value of 0 is 0. Next, arrange the following numbers in ascending order. Ascending order means we have to arrange the number from the smaller to larger. First, we have to look at the whole number part. 80, 21, 8 and 2. 8, 2. They are only with single digits. And 2 is the smallest one. So, 2.198 is the smallest decimal number. Next, 80, 21, 8. So, next, 8.030 is the smallest. And next, 80 and 21. 21.98 and then 80.30. We have arranged the decimals in ascending order. We have to put less than sign for ascending order. For ascending order, we must use less than sign. For descending order, we must use greater than sign. 2.198 is less than, 8.030 is less than, 21.98 is less than 80.30. Next, convert the unlike decimal into like decimal. Like decimal means after the decimal point we must have same number of place value. Here after the decimal point we are having two place values, and here after the decimal point we are having one place value, and here after the decimal point we are having three place value, and here after the decimal point we are having three place value. So we are going to compare these two decimal number so that after the decimal point we are having three decimal places. 12.98, already we are having two places, so put 10. Next, 45.6, here we have to put two zeros. Here 98.001. Keep this as it is because after the decimal point we are having three places. And here 11.981. Here also after the decimal point we are having three places. So we have converted all these decimal numbers into like decimals. We have converted unlike decimal into like decimal by adding zeros. So in today's class, we have solved all the problems in the worksheet. Thank you, students.